Hello students, in continuation with the last lecture on friction, today we are going to discuss on adhesive friction. So when two surfaces are brought into contact, bonding across the interface takes place, and to pull apart the two solid bodies, we need adhesive force. So when two bodies come into contact, the contact takes place at the level of asperities. And when you try to pull these two contact surfaces apart, you have to apply a force, and this particular force is called adhesive force. So adhesive force is the force which is acting between these two contacting surfaces, and the adhesive force increases with the growth in the asperities. If it means if there the asperities will grow into dimensions, the contact between the two surfaces, the real area of contact between two surfaces increases, and that's why there is an increase in adhesive force. Now there is one more force which is called cohesive force, and the cohesive force is the force which acts in the bulk of the material between atoms and molecules. However, adhesion is a force which acts on the surfaces in contact. So the ratio of this compressive force which is applied initially for making two surfaces in contact, and the force which is required to pull apart these two surfaces, if we have a ratio of these two forces, like the force which is required to pull apart these two surfaces to the original normal load, is called the coefficient of adhesion. Now, adhesion occurs in solid-solid contacts, and it occurs at the proximity of asperities. And like friction, adhesion is also sometimes desirable and sometimes undesirable, because wherever you want strong bonding, you need strong adhesion force. And wherever you want control adhesion, you like weak adhesive forces. And there may be physical or chemical adhesion in nature, and between two contacting surfaces, and because the chemical interaction involves covalent bond, ionic and electrostatic bonds and metallic bonds, whereas the physical interaction involves hydrogen bond and van der Waals bond. So therefore it is said that adhesion is a function of material pair and interface conditions. So this material pair and interface conditions are like the crystal structure and crystallographic orientations, solubility of one material into another, chemical activity and separation of charges, surface cleanliness, normal load, temperature, duration of contact, and separation rate. So these are the properties which normally affect the the material pair and interface conditions. So it said that this additional force is the generally increased linearly with increase in normal load. So you can see from this graph, as you increase the normal load, the adhesive force increases. If we increase the duration of contact, these are the two lines which are for 10 seconds and 1000 seconds for a steel sphere of 3 mm diameter. So it is increasing linearly with normal load. Now it also depends on the properties of the material. Like if a material is having high roughness and modulus of elasticity, if it lacks ductility, means there exhibits lower real area of contact, and that's why there is a lower adhesion. However, if there is a plastic deformation or viscoplastic or viscoelastic deformation between two surfaces, and that will increase the real area of contact, and of course it will increase the duration of contact, which leads to the increase in the adhesion. So by this graph you can see as the duration of contact increases, the coefficient of adhesion also increases. Now, but the adhesion depends on true and apparent area of contacts, because the real or true area is the fraction of the apparent area which is available between two contacting surfaces. So it is a fraction of apparent area, and the load is being supported by the deformation of this contacting asperities and discrete contact spots. So this is the real area which is normally supporting the load which is acting on two contacting surfaces. And the rupture of this asperities takes place either at interface or in one of the mating bodies. So from the classical theory of adhesion, we can say that this frictional force is defined as depends on the real area of contact and the average shear strength of the asperities. So this average force of friction is equal to real area of contact into tau A. Now you can also, that is for dry friction or dry contact case. If you have a wet contact or partially liquid film, you can use this equation for determining the average frictional force. It involves the constant alpha and it involves the average shear stress as well as it involves the shear stress of lubricating film. So the shear stress of lubricating film you can calculate using eta L into V by H, where eta is the absolute viscosity of the lubricant, V is the relative sliding velocity and H is the liquid film thickness. So by this formula, if there is a liquid film between two surfaces, you can calculate the average frictional force. Because the contribution or adhesion is always there between two surfaces where there is a friction, so we can also calculate the coefficient of adhesive friction in dry contact using this formula: mu A is equal to AR tau A upon W, or mu A is equal to tau A upon PR, where PR is the mean real pressure. So in this way you can calculate the coefficient of adhesive friction. So this adhesion is always present between the solids which are in contact, either in sliding motion or in rotating motion. So that's all for this lecture. Next we will discuss about the sliding and rolling friction. Thank you, students.